Good morning and welcome to St. Thomas's Episcopal Church on this first Sunday of Advent, November 28th. Our service begins on page 355 of the Book of Common Prayer. Bless the Lord who forgives all our sins. His mercy endures forever. Almighty God, to you all hearts are open, all desires known, and from you no secrets are hid. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. The Lord be with you. Let us pray. Almighty God, give us grace to cast away the works of darkness and put on the armor of light. Now, in the time of this mortal life in which your Son, Jesus Christ, came to visit us in great humility, that in the last day, when he shall come again in his glorious majesty to judge both the living and the dead, we may rise to the life immortal through him who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
Jeremiah chapter 33, verses 14 through 16. The days are surely coming, says the Lord, when I will fulfill the promise I made to the house of Israel and the house of Judah. In those days and at that time, I will cause a righteous branch to spring up for David, and he shall execute justice and righteousness in the land. In those days, Judah will be saved, and Jerusalem will live in safety. And this is the name by which it shall be called: The Lord is our righteousness. Hear what the Spirit is saying to God's people.
A reading from Psalm 25. To you, O Lord, I lift up my soul. My God, I put my trust in you. Let me not be humiliated, nor let my enemies triumph over me. Let none who look to you be put to shame. Let the treacherous be disappointed in their schemes. Show me your ways, O Lord, and teach me your paths. Lead me in your truth and teach me, for you are the God of my salvation. In you have I trusted all the day long. Remember, O Lord, your compassion and love, for they are from everlasting. Remember not the sins of my youth and my transgressions. Remember me according to your love and for the sake of your goodness, O Lord. Gracious and upright is the Lord, therefore he teaches sinners in his way. He guides the humble in doing right and teaches his way to the lowly. All the paths of the Lord are love and faithfulness to those who keep his covenant and his testimonies.
A reading from Paul's first letter to the Thessalonians. How can we thank God enough for you in return for all the joy that we feel before our God because of you? Night and day we pray most earnestly that we may see you face to face and restore whatever is lacking in your faith. Now may our God and Father himself and our Lord Jesus direct our way to you. And may the Lord make you increase and abound in love for one another and for all, just as we abound in love for you. And may he so strengthen your hearts in holiness that you may be blameless before our God and Father at the coming of our Lord Jesus with all his saints. Hear what the Spirit is saying to God's people.
Thank you. Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Luke. Jesus said, "There will be signs in the sun, the moon, and the stars, and on earth distress among nations confused by the roaring of the sea and the waves. People will faint from fear and foreboding of what is coming upon the world, for the powers of the heavens will be shaken. Then they will see the Son of Man coming in a cloud with power and great glory. Now, when these things begin to take place, stand up and raise your head, because your redemption is drawing near." Then he told a parable. "Look at the fig tree and all the trees. As soon as they sprout leaves, you can see for yourselves and know that summer is already near. So also when you see these things taking place, you know that the kingdom of God is near. Truly I tell you, this generation will not pass away until all these things have taken place. Heaven and earth will pass away, but my words will not pass away. Be on your guard, so that your hearts are not weighed down with dissipation and drunkenness and the worries of this life, that day may catch you unexpectedly like a trap. For it will come upon all who live on the face of the whole earth. Be alert at all times, praying that you may have the strength to escape all these things that take place and to stand before the Son of Man." The Gospel of the Lord. All right, even though you just heard me read the psalm, I mean the gospel, I'm going to preach on the psalm today. And today's psalm says, "Show me your ways, O Lord, and teach me your paths." The way of the Lord. Paths. These are metaphors used throughout the Bible to describe our journey with God. Since we believe God is everywhere, and in everything, and there is no place where God is not, then I don't believe it's even possible to not be with God during our individual journeys. And I think God will never rest until everything and everyone finds their way back to Him. So within each of our lives, we have choices to make, choices about which paths we're going to choose on this journey. Some paths are easier, some are challenging. Speaking through the prophets Baruch and Isaiah, God assures us that He could and would make this journey easier for us by filling valleys and lowering mountains and straightening out hairpin turns and putting new backdrop on roads that are filled with, I don't know, potholes and frost eaves, things like that. Of course, God would like to do that, because we are God's children. And we do the same thing with our children. Do you notice that? We want to make their lives as wonderful and as safe and as unstressful as we can. And does it work? I don't know. You tell me. Hasn't worked with my daughter so far. Despite my best efforts, she persists in climbing dangerous mountains to get where she wants to go, to taking hairpin turns when she chooses, metaphorically speaking, and makes my stomach clench and my hands go over my eyes when she does it. But it's her journey. It's hers and God's. And all our paths are different, every single one of them. A path is merely a way or a track laid down by many weary feet, or excited feet, or just feet, making a path. I asked the people at a Wednesday healing service a long time ago what images came to their minds when they heard the word path. I thought it was really interesting. So what kind of paths resonated with them? And one person described a superhighway, I'll never forget this, like a 15-lane highway, that all of us are on in some way, shape, or form. I thought that was amazing. I can honestly say I've never thought of a path that way. And some people are in the fastest lane, say lane 15, and some have stopped in the breakdown lane, and there are other places to get nourishment along this highway, to fix a flat, to stop and rest. You move into the slow lanes when you need to. I just thought it was an amazing metaphor. Amazing. And another picture that I got was somebody who said they like mountain paths filled with adventure. Another saw a footpath in the woods that would make my heart ring out. That really resonates with me. Under the trees. And I often think of the passage as like a path on the beach, flanked by the ocean of God. Though I still like the one in the woods better. So what do you think of when you think of a path? What kind of path are you on? What metaphor would work for you? So throughout our lives, our journey to God brings us along many terrains, many climates, many everything, and we have choices. Do you remember a time when your path of life gave you a choice of several different ways to go? You could almost like see it laid out in front of you that way. I could go this way, I could go this way, I could go this way. And I remember something like that happening to me, not once, but several times in my life. And I had to make a choice. And I'm still having to make choices. Seems like every day lately because of the pandemic, but you know what I mean. You still have choices. Until the day you die, you have choices. Physicists. I love physicists. I would never be a physicist because my brain won't do that. But physicists have discovered that there are multiple realities that exist all at the same time, all around us. I think that is an amazing idea. And each of the choices that we make in this reality and other choices and other roads chosen are played out in other realities. So we might make one choice here, but in another reality, we choose the second path. Or in another reality, we choose the third path. And sometimes I kind of wish I could see all the different choices, all the choices I made in my life, and what the outcomes were of all the different choices in my life. But I'm reminded of a passage in the Chronicles of Narnia that I've never forgotten, where Lucy makes a disastrous decision. She was always my favorite character. And then she asks Aslan what would have happened if she'd made the right choice. And he turns to her and he says, "To know what would have happened, child? Nobody has ever told that." "Oh dear," said Lucy. "But anyone can find out what will happen," Aslan says. Aslan, of course, is the Jesus figure in the Chronicles of Narnia. Now, there's no going back in this life. There's no do-overs. I wish. But there's always a chance to go forward. Onward, onward, onward. We will pick the roads that resonate with us as God meant us to. We will make the choices that we make as God means us to. Some prefer mountains to climb. Others prefer the speed and directness of a superhighway in one lane or the other. For many, it's the mystery and the quiet of the woods, and others thrive on a kind of slow, melodious, sun-drenched trail through the grass. It's our path. We can choose the one we want. And we can always veer into the unknown and then come back to the familiar paths. After all, it's our journey, our way to God. And if we get lost or tired, God will fill up those valleys and bring down those self-imposed mountains. And whatever path we choose, God will be with us every step of the way. Show me your ways, O Lord, and teach me your paths. Amen.
We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he became incarnate from the Virgin Mary and was made man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son. With the Father and Son, he is worshipped and glorified. He is spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Let us pray for the church and for the world. Grant, Almighty God, that all who confess your name may be united in your truth, live together in your love, and reveal your glory in the world. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Guide the people of this land and of all the nations in the ways of justice and peace, that we may honor one another and serve the common good. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Give us all a reverence for the earth as your own creation, that we may use its resources rightly in the service of others and to your honor and glory. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Bless all whose lives are closely linked with ours, and grant that we may serve Christ in them and love one another as he loves us. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Comfort and heal all those who suffer in body, mind, or spirit. Give them courage and hope in their troubles, and bring them the joy of your salvation. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. And we pray especially for Virginia Carboy, Kathy Delano, Victoria Burgesson, Anthony Clark, the Gibson family, Cheryl, Joe, Catherine, John Conrad, Pat Carpenter, Catherine, and Evan Hickman. And Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer.
Let us confess our sins against God and our neighbor. Most merciful God, we confess that we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We are truly sorry and we truly repent. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us and forgive us, that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways to the glory of your name. Amen. Almighty God, have mercy on you, forgive you all your sins through our Lord Jesus Christ, strengthen you in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep you in eternal life. Amen. The peace of the Lord be always with you. Once again, welcome to St. Thomas's Episcopal Church on this glorious Sunday, November 28th. Stewardship. It is the time of stewardship, so please get in your pledge cards and be generous with every perfect gift that comes from above. And we will bless all of the pledges on December 12th will be our in-gathering. But don't wait until then. You can pledge a couple of different ways. In the envelope that was provided to you that came to your house, you can do it online, or you can, I think that's only two ways you can do it. So please get in your stewardship pledge. We would appreciate it. Thank you very much. We have expanded office hours, and I want to reiterate that again, that we have four lovely volunteers who are volunteering Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday from 9 to noon. So that should be helpful for those of you that need to get in on Friday to do Altar Guild and Flower Guild. So take advantage, come in and say hi to Grace. She's our newest volunteer. And introduce yourself. Walk in love. as Christ loved us and gave himself for us, an offering and sacrifice to God. Our service continues with Holy Eucharist on page 361 of the Book of Common Prayer. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right and a good and joyful thing always and everywhere to give thanks to you, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, because you sent your beloved Son to redeem us from sin and death and to make us heirs in him of everlasting life, that when he shall come again in power and great triumph to judge the world, we may without shame or fear rejoice to behold his appearing. Therefore we praise you, joining our voices with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, who forever sing this hymn to proclaim the glory of your name. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Holy and gracious Father, in your infinite love, you made us for yourself. And when we had fallen into sin and become subject to evil and death, you, in your mercy, sent Jesus Christ, your only and eternal Son, to share our human nature, to live and die as one of us, to reconcile us to you, the God and Father of all. He stretched out his arms upon the cross and offered himself in obedience to your will, a perfect sacrifice for the whole world. On the night he was handed over to suffering and death, our Lord Jesus Christ took bread, and when he had given thanks to you, he broke it and gave it to his disciples and said, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." After supper, he took the cup of wine, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Therefore, we proclaim the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. We celebrate the memorial of our redemption, O Father, in this sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving. Recalling his death, resurrection, and ascension, we offer you these gifts. Sanctify them by your Holy Spirit to be for your people the body and blood of your Son, the holy food and drink of new and unending life in him. Sanctify us also, that we may faithfully receive this holy sacrament and serve you in unity, constancy, and peace. And at the last day, bring us with all your saints into the joy of your eternal kingdom. All this we ask through your Son, Jesus Christ, by him and with him and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit. All honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever. Amen. And now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. Christ our Passover is sacrificed for us. Therefore, let us keep the feast. The gifts of God, for the people of God, take them in remembrance that Christ died for you, and feed on him in your hearts by faith with thanksgiving.
In union, O Lord, with your faithful people at every altar of your church, where the Holy Eucharist is now being celebrated, I desire to offer to you praise and thanksgiving. I remember your death, Lord Christ. I proclaim your resurrection, and I await your coming in glory. Since I cannot receive you today in the sacrament of your body and blood, I beseech you to come spiritually into my heart. Cleanse and strengthen me with your grace, Lord Jesus, and let me never be separated from you. May I live in you and you in me in this life and in the life to come. Amen.
And now on page 365, let us pray. Eternal God, gracious Father, you have graciously accepted us as living members of your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, and you have fed us with spiritual food in the sacrament of his body and blood. Send us now into the world in peace and grant us strength and courage to love and serve you with gladness and singleness of heart through Christ our Lord. Amen. Let us remember that life is short, and we do not have much time to gladden the hearts of those who travel the way with us. So be swift to love, and make haste to be kind. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon you, and remain with you always. Amen.